Okay, so this is round two for summer chef demo that we're doing. Today we're going to be doing sourdough capellini arrabbiata. So let's start off with the front side of that. This is Sasha. Sasha is about 3 months old. Sasha's name comes from Saccharomyces, which is the strain of yeast that makes our sourdough starter that we use in the house. We use it to make our pasta, we use it to make our pizza, I use it for anything you possibly imagine. Crepes, French baguette, waffles, all types of stuff. Great stuff. That's a recipe for another day though. So, we used her to make the capellini pasta that you have today. That was made with an extruder. Normally in the restaurant we use a laminator, which means that it gets rolled through a machine instead of pushed through a machine. So, this stuff that you have was pushed through a machine. Arrabbiata is an Italian sauce, red sauce, that translates to angry. Called such because of the chili peppers that it has in it. I included cayenne pepper in your mix. We have a mixture in here that I'm going to be using of both cayenne and Aleppo peppers. Aleppos are one of my favorite. It comes out of Aleppo, Syria. Not terribly spicy, but has a nice smoky flavor when it's dried. A little bit oily, really good pepper if you can find it. Alright, so just like we talked about last time, mise en place. Mise en place is very important. This is my mise en place setup right here. Mise en place, everything in its place. That's what that means. So we've got our dry ingredients, we've got our pre-prepped vegetables, oil and vinegar, pasta, we're good to go. So first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna take a prep bowl, dump all of our chopped up veggies in here. You can use any type of veggies you really want. I've made this before with both zucchini and yellow squash. Any number of peppers, tomatoes, especially this season, you can get the really nice like heirloom tomatoes. Eggplant works great. So, start with adding all those together, season it up. We're going to add a decent amount of salt, probably about a tablespoon or so. Dried oregano. You can use fresh oregano, but I wouldn't use it at this point in the recipe. You're going to want to use this if it's fresh at the tail end of the recipe, or else it's just going to end up burning up and not having any flavor. And then the appropriate amount of spice to your taste. I included with your kits about a tablespoon of spice. It is cayenne, so it's got a pretty hefty kick to it, so if you need to go a little bit lighter, that's fine too. I like it a little bit spicy, so I'm going to go ahead and kill this whole thing. Extra virgin olive oil. About a tablespoon, maybe a little bit heavier than that. If you can, reserve a little bit of your oil because we can incorporate it into the sauce later on in the recipe. And if you need to use a little bit more than what I gave you, that's fine too. Give it a good toss. Line it with either wax paper or parchment paper. If you have a seal pad, that looks good too. Spread your veggies on there. Spread them out nice and evenly. It's really important to have an even layer. You don't want to have everything stacked up on top of each other, or else it's not going to cook the same. Now, one thing that you can do that would help a little bit is cover up your onions just a touch if there's too many of them sticking out. Onions have the most sugar of everything in here, and they're going to burn a little fastest. So just a little precautionary thing. Now, speaking of burning, we're going to bring this over to the oven. You want to get a lot of color on this sauce today. Okay, I have a super oven. So, not the best translation, but I'm only setting mine to about 411 because it has an extremely powerful fan in here. You're going to probably want yours more like 425-ish. It took a little longer than that. I'm going to start it with about 10 minutes, and then after those 10 minutes are up, I'm going to take a spatula and I'm going to move around the vegetables in here so that it doesn't cook only on one side and it keeps it even. While those go into the oven, I have a pot of pasta water going over here, cranked up all the way. If you want to boil it, already put some salt in that. Very important to season your pasta water. You want to put in about 3%. Or make it taste like seawater. It should taste like the sea. It should taste like ocean water. That's how it's properly seasoned. You don't have to do this, but also another thing I like to do is just add just a little bit of oil. It helps the pasta not stick. well real quick. Head back to our station. Real quick. Most pastas take about 12 to 15 minutes, depending on how thick it is. This is cappellini, also called angel hair pasta. Very, very, very thin. So it's going to take anywhere from 8 to 10 minutes, roughly. Add it in there. Let it kind of hang out for just a second. That's what it's liable to actually get in there. You're going to give it one turn. I like to set a timer for about 3 minutes. And then every time that timer goes off, stir your pasta. You don't have to stand here babysitting it. But you don't want to leave it alone. It will stick together. It's not very fun trying to get it done. So one quick stir. Is that my timer? Okay. Well, look at that. I already found one. When the pasta's ready, you're going to dump it into your strainer, whether that's like a China cap or a colander, whatever you will. Save that pasta water. We're going to use this. Okay, we're going to bring it back over to our station. By the time your pasta's done, your vegetables should be pretty close to being done roasted. This is going to look a little dark, but this is good. This is what you want. You want lots of color. All that extra color that we have on here, that's caramelization. That's all the sugars that are in the vegetables developing flavor. Drying out a little bit. It's going to make for a very robust, rich sauce. Now from here, you can do several different methods. Personally, when I'm making this sauce, I like to use a food processor. And that's what we're going to do here. You can also use a blender. You can also use like a stick or an immersion blender. That works really good too. If you don't have any of those fancy toys, you can technically throw all this stuff back into your prep bowl and use like a potato masher or something of this likeness to just mash it up and slowly add in little bits of water at a time. That'll form a nice, very rustic sauce.
Are you going to use the pasta water for that, or are you going to use regular tap water?
I would always use pasta water. During pre-season, it's going to be hot, so it's not going to wrench the temperature down on your pasta. We're going to take all this, and even though, yes, color is definitely what we're going for, if you do happen to notice any, especially the onions, any onions that are a little bit too far gone, like that guy, that's just charcoal. We don't want charcoal. You go ahead and pick them out. The color is good. Alright, that's just regular. Also included in your kit, I have sherry vinegar. Sherry vinegar is my preferred vinegar. It's not super hard to find. I would recommend like Trader Joe's, PPC, Metropolitan Market, any of those places will have a pretty decent sherry vinegar. It has a lot of flavor. If you like balsamic vinegar, you're going to love this stuff. It's great. It has a nice almondy, sweet kind of flavor to it. It's really, really good stuff. So, included in your kit, I think I have about a tablespoon of vinegar. That's probably about the appropriate amount for this. So, just enough to get the flavor. Adding acid in your food is very important. You need to think of adding acid in your food as adding seasoning. When you're saying to season your food, that doesn't just mean adding salt. That means adjusting the sweetness level, that means adjusting the salt level, the acid level. Vinegar is very important seasoning. I'm going to give it a quick few pulses just to see where we're at for the start. Okay, so already I can see I'm going to need to utilize some of this pasta water. Well, it's going to go a pretty long way, so I'm going to start with about a tablespoon or two. Okay, it's looking a lot better. I'm also going to use some of that olive oil that I reserved. This is going to get absorbed right by the sauce, and it's going to add some depth and just make it really robust and clear. Water. We're almost there. Just easy does it when you're adding it. You can always add more. You can't take it out. Just a little bit further. Alright, let's see what we got. does that mean? That means how smooth you want your sauce, how thick you want it. This is spaghetti, so spaghetti doesn't really adhere as nicely as something like penne would. So penne has the holes in it. Those holes actually have function, it's not just a fun shape. Those holes are designed to hold sauce, they're vessels. Spaghetti doesn't do that. Spaghetti's designed for just being lightly cooked. Kind of what we got going on here with calories. So we want something that's smoother and is going to hold on to that pasta. That was pretty good. Okay, cool. Alright, now you're going to take your pasta. And you can do this one or two ways. I think personally it presents a lot better. In this case, anyway, to have the pasta sitting on top or under the sauce rather than actually tossed in. If you want to toss it in, that's fine. Says it's very important to dress well, and I agree, so we're going to take a little bit of garnish. I just picked some of this out of my garden, a little bit of flat leaf parsley. And some chrysanthemums. Just give it a little pop of color. Alright, there we go. Sourdough cappellini arrabbiata.
Delicious.
Does anybody have any questions for the chef? Thank you.
You're very welcome.